meanwhile, we turn to our next display item. It is the unmistakable Aerosuperbatics Wingwalkers. The team leader, Dave Barrell, calls smoke on go. And then puts it on.
And apart from being the coolest car in this location during the display, the two girls on top of the wings being blown to pieces, take a good look at their positions when the aeroplane come by. The girls, like the aircraft, are usually in formation, whether they're upside down, right way around, or whatever they're doing.
Yes, using the swiveling rig that Aerosuperbatics themselves developed. The two girls on the wings today are Kirsten Popjoy on the lead aircraft, and Libby Dover-Smith following on. Orange livery at Aerosuperbatics, the operating company behind this team, which isn't currently with a title sponsor, whereas the second aeroplane is in their corporate wingwalking livery, because you can now go and wingwalk with the team. Their beautiful former Royal Flying Corps First World War airfield at Rencombe in the Cotswolds. They offer wingwalking experiences on that Stearman with one of their incredibly experienced display pilots at the helm.
Well, and if he doesn't turn up, Dave Barrell will do the job just as nicely.
As I said, Dave leading the pair, and we're very privileged today to have as number two the man who founded this team, one of the great showmen on the display circuit, Vic Norman. The most experienced wing-walking pilot in the world. Now, they come in towards us for the break. Camera's ready. Give them a wave because they have a fantastic view. They have the best seats in the house up there, there's no doubt. But, as Keith was saying, it is extremely windy. The G-forces to which they're being subjected are considerable. And that's before you consider the bugs and flies on your teeth.
Those young ladies are very fit, and they need to be.
They do. When you look at their CVs and their interests, a lot of them are into things like gymnastics and yoga. Circus arts and so forth. Sorry, Keith, yes.
Yes, they certainly are, but more importantly, they are completely enthusiastic. They love their jobs.
Year in the 1980s and saw a wingwalking act on a Stearman like the ones we see here. Standing on the wing acts had been a part of British air shows for many years, with the Tiger Club that we were just talking about, in particular using Tiger Moths. But of course, the Tiger Moth, a very low powered aeroplane. Vic realised that you could add so much to the act by using a big, powerful Stearman. And it's moved on from that to using the uprated 450 horsepower Pratt & Whitney engines, Stearmans that are the mainstays of the team today. Over the years, Nick and his company have taken things several stages further with the swivelling rigs, for example, and with numerous record attempts, such as the shortest baton passed between two wing walkers in flight. Kirsten Popjoy flying on the lead aircraft in her third season with the team. She greatly enjoys performing handstands, climbing around the aircraft. She says, zooming across the globe in a whirlwind of vintage glamour. And that's exactly what this team conveys. Period when wingwalking first came about, and in those days it meant exactly what it says. People would get up on the wings of a biplane and walk around them unprotected and unattached. Now, of course, the use of extensive and very, very tough safety harnesses is mandated. They're very, very secure up there.
Although I still believe they can actually release themselves from the harness and allow themselves to climb down into the front seat, as long as they are restrained by one of the secure wires.
Absolutely, we'll see that, I expect, towards the end of their display, because they don't land back on the wing, they're always back down in the cockpit. Neither do they transit from display venue to display venue on the wing, which would be an even tougher experience for them.
An extremely high tension.
Yes.
Thank you as well.
Yes. They've gained a bit of height, as you can see, and I think we're going to see them once again putting on the smoke, diving down to build up energy. All the while, they're looking down on you, watching you. They hope you're enjoying this display as much as they're enjoying putting it on for you. Synchronized rolls. Flying on the number two aeroplane is Libby Dover-Smith, who joined Aerosuperbatics in 2004 when the team was still sponsored by Utterly Butterly. One of the many sponsorship incarnations they've been through over the years. They were the Crunchy Flying Circus for a long time, then Huntley Button, Team Pino, and the... And these guys, and their current one, they have performed all over the world. You have been them on some of these adventures, haven't you?
Yes, I did 3 years in China with them and then another one in Mongolia and had an absolute ball flying every day for 8 days, sometimes two and even three different displays in a day. And they work really hard.
They do, the aircraft get crated up and shipped out to the various further overseas territories that they've displayed in, and the list of them is simply endless. And in a lot of countries, like China that you were just mentioning, the wingwalking act had never been seen before, had it?
No, but the audiences in China were phenomenal, not just on the ground but on TV. And one particular year at Shenzhou, the audiences were in excess of a billion people. And numbers we just can't take on board.
Yes, yes. I gather from Vic Norman that the team is still known by some in China as UBB, but utterly, utterly barnstorms. On the upper wing initially, and then, as Keith mentioned, climbing down. One of the absolutely great military trainers of its day during the war years, the Boeing Stearman Cadet, known in his different versions, the PT-13 and PT-17 to the US Army Air Forces, the M2S to the US Navy.
Yeah.
their final pass. So, a final chance for a photograph, a final chance to give them a wave and show that you've enjoyed their considerable efforts on this windy day. In from the right, the 2021 Aerosuperbatics Wingwalkers. You can see them there, standing on one leg in front of the pilot's windscreen. A lot of upper body strength and core strength required for the wing walkers to use the swiveling rigs to the full.